I'm all about saving time in Google Drive, so these are the best Google Drive keyboard shortcuts. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and a somewhat concerning amount of Google content. So are you ready to learn some of my most used Google Drive shortcuts? Then let's go. First up, you can quickly change your Drive view simply by using one key. So I like to have grid view, but let's say we want to quickly switch to list view. Just hit the V key and you'll automatically be switched over to the other view. So now I'm in list view. Now, many of these remaining keyboard shortcuts will be familiar to you because you're most likely used to using them already in other applications. So now let's learn how to create documents using some keyboard shortcuts. Pay attention because we're going to create a new doc, sheet, form, slide, and drawing all with keyboard shortcuts. So to create a new doc from Google Drive, just hit your Shift and T keys. A new blank doc is opened for you in a new tab. Now, the same can be done for a Google Sheet, but this time you're going to hit Shift and S, and a spreadsheet is opened up in a new tab for you. Maybe you want to start a blank slide deck. Well, that is no problem. This time you're going to hit Shift and P, and a new presentation is opened for you. And of course, we can do the same with a form. So for this, we're going to hit our Shift and O keys to create a new Google form. Then finally, let's open a new Google drawing by hitting our Shift and D keys. Pretty neat. But there are other ways to quickly open up Google Docs and Sheets and the like. So if you can't remember these keyboard shortcuts, you can literally just head to your browser bar, not even in Google Drive, and type in docs.new, or you could even type in sheets.new, and so on. So would you look at this, our examples here, we have a new doc and sheet, or you could create a slide and things like that, just by using .new. Next up, you can quickly upload files to Drive using shortcuts as well. So from your Drive, you're just going to hit Shift and U, and your Finder window or your File Explorer window will be opened for you where you can just select the files you want to upload. And now that we know how to use shortcuts to create and upload files, let's use them to copy and paste files as well. So all we need to do for this is to select a file from Drive that we want to copy, and we're going to hit Command C on a Mac or Control C on Windows. And that's gonna automatically copy that file for you. So now that we've copied our item, let's paste it wherever we want. So let's say we wanna add it to this folder. We can just open the folder, hit Command V or Control V to paste that item into the folder. So just as expected, there is a copy of the file. So remember, this isn't moving the file or moving the folder. You're making a copy and then you're pasting that copy where you want. So you can click on it to rename it if you want, just depending on your organization. Now you could also copy and paste items into documents as direct links. So as an example, let's use our Shift T shortcut to create a new doc. And now back in my Drive, I'm going to Command C or Control C to save this file. Then back in the new doc I created, I'll just Command V or Control V to paste it right inside my new doc. So you can see it's created a link to that file right here in the doc, which is so helpful for shared docs with team members or presentations and the like. Now there's another way you can copy and paste items over as well. So from the file, you can actually hit Command Shift C or Control Shift C together. Then over in your doc, hit your Command V or your Control V. And you're gonna notice that you've pasted over a direct link to that original file, but this time Google's prompting you to hit Tab to make it a prettier clickable link that provides a file preview upon hover. This is actually a really great example of a smart chip in Google Docs, which I've talked about in a Google Docs video that I have linked to in the description below. Smart chips are a really great way to access more information and have more information available right within your Google Doc in a little snapshot for you. Now, it's worth noting that you can copy and paste folders the exact same way, but also you can select multiple files at once. So if we wanted to select all of these files, for example, we can just hit Command A or Control A to select all. Then we're just gonna hit our copy shortcut of Command or Control C, and then we're going to paste those over where we want. So if I wanna add them to another folder in Drive, I'm just gonna Command or Control V, and boom, copies of all these files are pasted at once. And by the way, if you want to ever undo your last action, of course, you know, you can just hit Command Z or Control Z and you'll undo that last move. All right, the fifth set of Google Drive shortcuts is to create and move folders. Listen, whatever can save me a click, you know I am here for it. So to create a new folder, we're just gonna hit Shift and F. I swear to you, it's really that easy. So now let's say we want to move a folder or file. So we don't want to just copy it over like we have learned, but we want to actually reorganize our drive and move it completely. Well, all we're gonna do is either with the folder or file selected is hit Command X or Control X. And what this does is it actually cuts the item for you. So rather than copy it, we're cutting it from its current location, and then we're going to head over to where we want to move it, and we're going to use our Command or Control V shortcut, and now our folder or file, or multiple files as we've learned how to do, will be moved to their new location. So last up, you can quickly pull up detailed information on a file or folder in Drive. This is so handy. With our file or folder selected, just hit the D key. You're gonna see who has access to the item, who created it, when it was created, who last modified it and when, and so many more details. So these are just a few of my most used Google Drive keyboard shortcuts. And don't worry if you can't remember them all. I've actually linked to a full list of Google Drive keyboard shortcuts for you in the description below. And if you just can't get enough and you want even more Google Drive videos, well, guess what? I've linked to a whole whack of Google Drive videos in the description below for you as well. So what do you think of these Google Drive keyboard shortcuts? What are your favorites? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here and here for even more Google Drive content. Thanks for watching. See you next time.